Welcome to Geek with Dev. Today we're going.
Hey guys, welcome to Geek with Dev. This is an exclusive interview with Mike Quinn. He is mostly known for Star Wars, but you guys know that I'm a big Jim Henson fan, so it's a pleasure to be here with you. Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah, I'm a big Jim Henson fan too.
Yeah,
that's how I got started actually.
Yeah, so you worked with Jim Henson in 1982 on The Dark Crystal.
I worked with Jim initially in 1980 on The Great Muppet Caper.
Yeah, okay,
And then The Dark Crystal was sort of, we were in pre-production at the same time, so we were doing film tests for The Dark Crystal during 80, and we actually filmed it during 81, and it was released in 82. So yeah, it was kind of like a two-picture deal that Jim had, Great Muppet Caper and Dark Crystal back-to-back with the same crew.
And so did you enjoy working on The Dark Crystal?
Yeah, it was amazing. I mean, it was
definitely an experience.
It was a first, because it was the first animatronic film ever. I mean,
absolutely.
So we had to figure out, how do we make these things move? You know, we didn't know how to make them walk properly, or what happens with the faces to make them realistic. How do you make them blink realistically, and when do the eyes move? And when is... what is too much, what is not enough, you know. It's not just like doing a Muppet where you can do a little bounce, you know. Everything has to have a much more realistic sort of walk and things like that.
And recently there's been like a Netflix has produced a show, the Dark Crystal Age of Resistance. Did you get a chance to take a look at that?
I'm about 4 episodes in right now, so we're trying to see them all.
And what do you think? Because they minimize CGI.
Yeah, you know, that's the thing. I mean, ideally, producers and directors and shows and films should use CG for what it does best, and they should use puppets for what it does best. And they seem to be doing that now, I think. You know, we're getting that in the Star Wars films and in The Dark Crystal.
Oh, yeah.
So there's a maturing of the industry finally where we're seeing the best of both worlds, you know, and where they can work together. And that was something I think Jim Henson was always quite interested in.
Yeah.
He loved the technology and seeing how that could enable him to create better worlds and stories and make new characters. So he was always interested in that side of things anyway. So I think he'd be quite happy with it.
Jim Henson, I think he'd be fascinated by it. And
In the
movies, he really wants to transport you into a different world and a different dimension.
Yeah.
And he really did that with Labyrinth. So do you have any cool stories or funny interactions with working on Labyrinth?
We had a lot of fun. I mean, Jim, he looked like he had the best time ever directing that film for
a start,
you know. He just seemed so happy doing that. But, there was like, as puppeteers, we get up to mischief sometimes.
Of course.
So, I don't know if you know, there's a David Bowie song he did in the 1960s called Laughing Gnome.
Laughing Gnome, of course.
Novelty record.
So familiar, yeah. So, he did not like that song.
Right, so therefore, as a naughty puppeteer, I got the sound guy to play that back on set. You know where Bowie first comes into the room with Sarah and with the baby?
Oh, yeah.
And we had all the goblins kind of hiding in the bed and the drawers and closets and stuff. So when we sort of rehearsed that scene out, the sound guy played that song back, and we all popped up and sung that song.
Really?
And I thought, I'm going to get fired. We're going to be in so much trouble. But Jim laughed and David Bowie laughed.
David laughed?
He chuckled. He was a good
spirit.
He's
a good spirit, of course.
He was
great.
And I didn't lose my job. I kept my job. So
which is a good thing.
We did things like that quite often on the film.
And so, just one quick question. So since you're watching the Dark Crystal new series, if anything were to happen with Labyrinth, would you like to see, because it's such a classic now, would you like to see them dive into that world again, or do you think that they should just leave it alone?
I would love to see that. I'd be really, really curious to see if they could get Jennifer Connelly as she is now, you know,
absolutely,
sort of maybe as a mother or whatever. I don't know, sort of move the story forward.
Yeah.
You know, because you can't have David Bowie anymore. Obviously, you can't really go back in time, and you can't replace him. There's no way.
There's no way you can replace David Bowie.
Right. So, but it would be really interesting to if they could get hold of her and have her be in the series.
Yeah.
Wouldn't that be amazing?
That would be amazing, yeah.
So I'd like to see that.
And so just to wrap it up, you are just finished shooting season 2 of KIDDING.
Right, with Jim Carrey.
It's on
Showtime, and it starts up, I think, November 3rd or
November
something 3rd. Like that.
So the first season went well?
It did
great.
It was up for some awards, nominations and stuff. And it's very smart writing, very adult, you know.
Yeah.
You know, he's about this, he has his own a kid show in the show. It's a show within a show, so I'm one of the puppet characters that he has on the show.
Yep.
And season 2, I think, promises to be even more interesting, intriguing, great, just such great writing, really clever stuff. So I'm excited to see.
Absolutely.
Plus we have songs and it's
and so,
so much fun.
Yeah. So Jim Carrey has been kind of off the screen for a bit. How is he? How is he back on screen? Is he good on set and having a
very
good time?
Very good. Yeah. I think this is his first TV series in like 20 years or something.
Oh yeah.
But he's also an exec producer, but he's also the star of the show. So he has so much to do.
Oh yeah.
But Jim is such a collaborator. I really liked him. I mean, and we, you know, we got on well and stuff together on set, and we'd have little chats and things. It was really nice. But he's very collaborative and very, very, you know, always trying to see how he can plus something, make it better.
Another one of those kind spirits,
stuff,
right?
But you know, he was like helping us out and always, how about you try this and you know, what about this? He was really great. You know, really a very, you know, quiet guy. But very
in the zone.
Yeah, he's just very smart. You know.
All right.
So I've always got time for Jim. He was in good form.
All right.
And I'm excited to see the new series. So we're doing a lot more Muppet stuff again now, which is what I started out doing. So
Muppets,
we've got on Disney Plus new stuff coming out. So.
Yeah. Oh, on Disney Plus,
yeah.
Anyways, I appreciate you doing the interview with me.
Oh,
make sure you guys go check out KIDDING Season 2 once it's released. It's gonna be a good one. All right.
Oh yeah.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Cheers.